I hear people talking about the atheist experience.
Yes.
On this local channel.
You are a Marxist. You're an atheist. And you're from Russia.
So let me get your story straight. Your mother was on the brink of death, and then she was fine, right?
Yep.
And that's proof that God exists.
Yes.
Okay. What do you call it when a person is perfectly healthy and then drops dead? Is that proof that God does not exist?
No, that's just proof that whatever happens to that person happens.
Okay. So,
congratulations. You get the Caller of the Day award for being honest and answering your own question.
See, you're just atheist because y'all want to sin all the time.
That's it. You got it.
Pretty much. I'm a big fan of sin, I have to tell you.
We just decided this whole sin thing, it's for us, so pshaw. What was going on in your head when you sent this?
Right.
Did you think that we'd just never heard that verse before? Did you think that this one particular verse was going to be all someone needed to say, oh, what was I thinking? Here I am, an atheist, and God sent his only son to die for. Oh, why? Why didn't I realize that?
I'm vaccinated against smallpox, so all of you out there who'd like for God to demonstrate his power could simply pray for him to hit me with smallpox.
And determine whether or not it is more beneficial than harmful. What are its effects on the individual, the society? What kind of society does it produce when we allow things like slavery and genocide and infanticide? Why would any loving being ever order anything like that? Would you?
Wait, can you read that off again so I can figure out how many of those I've actually done?
Apostasy?
Oh, yeah.
Heresy?
Yeah.
Blasphemy?
You bet.
Witchcraft?
No.
Astrology?
No.
Adultery?
No.
Sodomy or homosexuality?
As long as there's an or in there? Yes.
Oh, okay. Incest?
No.
Good. Striking a parent?
Never.
Incorrigible juvenile delinquency?
Well, you'd have to ask my parents. I don't know how incorrigible I was. But.
And for women, unchastity before marriage. That doesn't apply to you.
It doesn't apply to me.
You're a man, so.
Evidently, I've got some work to do.
Right.
But I'm pretty much doomed on all counts, I would say.
A friend of mine, his little daughter, went to the baptism of her new cousin. And, you know, the mother's holding the baby up there, and the priest is mumbling words, and he's dumping the water on the head and rubbing it on the head. And his daughter looked up at him and said, Daddy, why is that man brainwashing the baby?
Like the banana's designed for us. It fits in the hand. It fits in your mouth.
It fits in your butt.
Why is God not real? Why is he?
Okay.
Do you believe in unicorns?
No.
Why?
Why?
Because unicorns are fairy tales, and it hasn't been proven that there is one.
You are the best caller! You are the best caller ever! You can answer your own questions every single time. You're done. It's evolution isn't just a theory. Evolution is a fact. Change over time is a fact. The theory of evolution by natural selection is the model that describes the process. That is constantly refined.
So you were studying to be a minister?
Yes.
And then now you don't believe in God?
That's correct.
Man, you the devil, man.